conditions are going to keep deteriorating for 10 minutes at least.
How do you feel the competition is for you this season? Great! Well, that's everything.
Here we are again then at Le Castellet for another round of this year's Formula One World Championship. Renault took their first French Grand Prix win all the way back in the inaugural race in 1906, but it was another 73 years before they could take their second. I'm sure Alpine will be pushing hard to delight the local fans here today.
Six lefts and nine rights give us a total of 15 corners here at the Circuit Paul Ricard, and a lap covers an overall distance of 3.6 miles. Average speeds will be somewhere in the region of 142 miles per hour, and they'll be maxing out on the Mistral Straight at around 205 miles per hour.
And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today, it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of Turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
Well, the throttle goes both ways, Crofty. You've got to have the discipline not to try and win the race on the first lap. So always be prepared to lift early and give those around you more space. Trying to be the last of the late breakers with half a dozen cars around you may pay off from time to time, but it's also a great way to lose your front wing.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Daniel Ricciardo starts from pole position today, and Valtteri Bottas will line up alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Verstappen, Lando Norris, and Sainz, Russell, Gasly, Ocon, and Antonio Giovinazzi, Schwartzman, Matsushita, Mick Schumacher, and Tsunoda, Leclerc, Latifi, Nikita Mazepin, and Lance Stroll, Vettel, they've taken a grid penalty, and more. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today?
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going. Don't panic just yet, but we've seen a problem at our end. We're looking into it. We can confirm that it's an issue with our engine. Some information on Russell. They're retiring from the race. That's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
A great race then, and a fantastic victory here at Paul Ricard. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it. The table has shrunk somewhat today. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Moore. They pushed and pushed and found some fantastic performance. It was just a pleasure to watch.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, AlphaTauri's strong weekend allows them to continue their march up the table. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time? Be sure to join us again as we continue to bring you the latest excitement in Formula One.
amazing performance out there. I'm sure you're pretty happy with that. Who would you say is your biggest rival at the moment? You really cut your way through the field today. What was your strategy? How do you feel seeing your teammate up on the podium? Last year, you had a much harder time on this track. What made the difference this time around? Great. Well, that's everything.
Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix.